Today we're going to cover what a data analyst actually does. This is important if you want to become a data analyst because this is exactly what you're going to be doing, or as precise as we can get because many of these data roles tend to overlap and change a bit depending on the company. I've seen data scientist roles that were basically data analysts, but I'm going to give you the most common things a data analyst does based on real job descriptions and actual tasks. I'll start with covering the responsibilities and then we'll cover the exact skills as well as the pay you can expect for different levels. And before we finish, I'm also going to compare it to other data roles like the data scientist, data engineer, and business analyst. And all of this is going to give you everything you need because to really understand what a data analyst does, you need to also understand the other data roles in a team and what they do as well. Let's get started. The responsibilities of a data analyst begin with understanding the objective and what actually needs to be done. In theory, just figuring this out is a pretty minor part, but because we often work in teams and in large companies or with the client, and stakeholders, it can take a lot of time back and forth to understand what actually needs to be done. And to do this, you will have to communicate a lot with different stakeholders. Once you finally understand the objectives and requirements, you'll have to collect data necessary for your project. It can be available in many different places. It could be a database, a spreadsheet, an external data source, or you might even have to collect it yourself. In this phase, it's all about acquiring and importing the necessary data from the sources. This can actually be a pretty tricky part because the data isn't always available. Like when you're downloading it on Kaggle and it's just clear. There may not be a perfect dataset available, you may have to try to combine different things and just be able to get the data you need somehow. Next, a data analyst needs to clean the data, for example using SQL. Here it is going to be all about identifying and handling missing values and errors. We want to remove any duplicates and correct any inconsistencies or errors in the data. A data analyst will also often want to normalize and standardize the data to make it easier to use later, and we need proper clean data to be able to draw good conclusions later from this data, so it is very, very important. How much direct data cleaning and data collection you'll do is also going to depend on your company and if you have other people in your team. For example, for one project, you may have someone like a data engineer help out with some parts, or you'll do it yourself. Next, a data analyst will move on to data exploration, and here it's going to be all about understanding the data and seeing what the data is trying to tell us. You may, for example, have to create some unique visualizations to understand the data and spot some trends, or just use different analytical techniques. Then, once you have something to work with, you'll communicate your findings by creating visualizations like dashboards using Tableau and Power BI and more. You may also write reports with your findings and recommendations to be able to present these findings in meetings or bring them to a stakeholder where you'll answer questions and so on. It is also critical to document what you do, and if you come from a programming background, you're going to be really familiar with the importance of documentation. This is especially important if you work in a larger team. You want to write down your methods used, your data sources, and any important decisions so that the process is clear and can be retraceable. A data analyst may also try to automate parts of their work. It can be creating an automated report, a continuous collection of data, or anything else to both systematize things and improve efficiency. When it comes to the exact skills, I want to base everything on real data from job listings on places like LinkedIn and Indeed, because that's where you're going to be looking for jobs. The YouTuber and analyst Luke made this awesome website where he scraped over 1.6 million job listings to see what skills employers actually look for. It is also scraping new job listings every single day to stay relevant in case things change. The first skill every data analyst needs to know, both to get hired but also day to day, is going to be SQL Structured Query Language. We use it to deal with databases and it's the number one in-demand skill for data analysts at this time. It's outcompeting every other skill when it comes to job listings, so make sure to learn SQL properly. I'm also going to leave some resources in the description to learn all of these skills as well. Next, we have Excel, and Excel is a very basic skill, but it's really important, especially because it allows you to work with non-technical team members. I mean, everyone can use Excel to some degree, but non-technical people, they don't really understand Python or SQL, so it's a huge plus to be able to do this. And now as a bonus, with AI and new technologies, Excel is also becoming more and more relevant again as these technologies are implemented in Excel, where we'll now be able to do more stuff that previously required other tools. Then we of course have Python, a programming language, and it's absolutely critical that you learn either Python or R. I would recommend Python as a beginner because it's more versatile and also more in demand on the job market. R may be a better option if you want to go more towards statistical analysis or academia, but in 90% of cases, I'd recommend Python for beginners because it's so versatile. And then we of course have Tableau or Power BI and some other tools as well. They are data visualization tools by Google and Microsoft. While they have some differences, they can do very similar things as well. They're competitors basically. quickly. Now, it does seem like Tableau is slightly more in demand, but as a Power BI user, I'm going to completely ignore that and say that both are great. Pick whatever you prefer. Data analysts also work with other tools. It can be Microsoft Azure, specific Python libraries like Panda and NumPy, SAS or SAS, and the other cloud platforms AWS or Azure. Again, it's all going to depend on what your company uses, so you'll have to learn the appropriate tools on the job if you don't know them already. But the ones I spoke about more in detail are really the key ones that most analysts use, and they're highly in demand on the job market, so focus on them and kind of learn the other things as you go along. It's really a challenge to talk about the pay for a data analyst position, because I know that while a lot of you guys are from the US, many of you are also from completely different countries. So these numbers will be for the US, but I think they can give you a good indication of the salaries regardless. A data analyst will have an average salary of about 90,000, and I'm going to divide it up into three different categories. We have the entry-level analyst with a salary of around 50 to 60,000. We have the mid-level analyst with a salary of around 70 to 90,000. And then we have the senior level with around 90 to 120. But again, it's possible to make a lot more and less, because it is absolutely impossible to give you an exact number. It's going to depend on many factors, your country, but even your state and your city. Now let's compare it to other data roles quickly. A data engineer is going to be focusing more on the infrastructure and management of the data itself. A business analyst is an analyst, but they're more connected with the business functions. And a data scientist will usually do more predictive analysis compared to an analyst, and it's a much more technical role as well. Data analysts do a lot of exciting things, and I hope this was helpful. Check the resources in the description if you want to become a data analyst, and check out this video next where I go deeper and compare data analysts to another data role. Have an amazing week, guys.